So today I'm going to show you how to get this great big voluminous curly hair with a hair straightener. I know there's a lot of videos on it, but a lot of people have requested this video, so I just wanted to get it up for you guys. It's really, really easy. I actually haven't curled my hair with a straightener in a really long time because I got so hooked on doing my waves. So yeah, if you guys want to see how to get this hair, then just keep watching the video. Thanks guys, bye. Okay, so the first thing that you want to do is you just want to brush out all your hair just to make sure there's no knots in it. It's easier, it's a lot easier to work with too. Okay, so then I spray my hair with a heat protectant. A lot of people will spray their hair like in sections and whatnot. You can do it that way. The way that I like to do it is just spray all of my hair all at once. Thermal protector that I have been using is the KQC Thermal Shine. Just looks like this. Actually really love this stuff. I feel like it does make my hair like super shiny. I use it before I blow dry my hair and before I straighten and curl or whatnot. So I just take mine, I hold my hair up, and I kind of just give it a spray like that. Ooh, right to the other side. Again, if you want to spray yours in sections, I mean, go ahead. So then, so then all you're going to need is a clip to clip up out of your hair, to clip your hair up out the way. So then I just section mine off regularly. I do kind of large sections. So we'll just clip this hair up and then we'll work on this bottom half. So I'm just going to take a strand probably about this big and my straightener. You can use whatever straightener you want. The one that I'm going to be using is the KQC Professional Ceramic X Heat. You just need to make sure that you have a straightener that is... What is happening here? You need to make sure that you have a straightener that is rounded on the edges so that you will be able to do like curls and flips and whatnot. So all you're going to do is you're going to take your straightener and you're going to place it wherever you want your curl to start. You can start up here, you can start down here, you can start wherever you want. But if you want your curl to go all the way up to kind of your roots, you want to start pretty high up. And you're just going to clamp it and then you're just going to flip it over. And then I just pull this hair over so it's easier to run through. And pull straight down. And the slower you pull, the more defined curl you will have. And if you pull kind of fast, you will have a more like wave instead. And I find that flat iron curls last better than any curl a curling iron can do. One more time, we're just gonna flip it over, pull this hair down. I like to hold my hair sometimes so that I make sure it gets through the iron. Okay, and then we'll just take it down and keep working in sections. It's really, really fast. I can literally do this all in like 10 minutes, not even, with all this weave in my hair. I know a lot of people are going to ask what I think of the KQC flat iron. I think it's amazing. It reminds me of my chi. I used to be obsessed with my chi, but I don't know if a lot of you guys have had this problem, but I found that the older my chi got, that when I would straighten my hair, I feel like it was like my hair would get stuck, and it would pull my hair, and I hated that. And then I had the pink TI Creative Style, something like that, that pink straightener. I know you guys have seen a bunch of my videos. I actually just gave that to a friend of mine. I liked that one for a long time. It's just the plates were so long and I don't know, I just didn't like how long the plates were. So that's why I got the KQC. It's like perfect. It's like a chi, but 10 times better in my opinion. Okay, because I know people are going to comment and be like, what do you think? Oh. Oh. Pull my weave out. Guess we'll just throw me into fast forward since I showed you guys the basics. So here we go. say you curled a hair that you didn't like how the curl looked so much, like this one right here that I just curled, it didn't come out how you want it, what you want to do is you want to make sure you just let that hair completely cool off, like move on to another hair and then come back to that one. Because if you try to recurl it while it's still hot, it's not going to do what you want and you're just going to get frustrated. So just let that hair cool and then come back to it. Bottom part. You don't have to recurl the whole top part either. You're just going to curl where you think it doesn't look so good. And then curl it with your finger. Like that.